Hey guys, welcome back, and today we're going to be trying something a bit different and look into some SCADA hacking. So SCADA is a category of software for controlling industrial processes, and specifically we're going to be looking into how to abuse Modbus. As you can see, it has its own Wikipedia page here. Essentially, Modbus is a communication protocol for transmitting information between electronic devices where data transactions are based on a master client requesting data or writing data to a slave or a server. If we go back to our Kali attack box, as you can see here, I have two panels, but before we can get started with some hacking, I need to show you how to set up the target environment. So here we have a Ubuntu 22 client. As you can see, we have a downloads folder. The first thing we have to do is navigate to sourceforge.net projects Modbus PAL, where you will find this Modbus simulator that we will be attacking. So click on download, and once you're done, you can go back to the downloads directory and you will find this modbus.jar file. Before we can proceed, there's something we have to do, and that would be reinstalling OpenJDK 11, because otherwise this jar file is just not going to compile correctly. You can do that with apt install openjdk 11 -jdk, and once that run, should be good. So we can actually start and we can compile this jar file with Java. So let's give it a try. We can do Java dash jar modbus pal dot jar, and as you can see here, it's going to be a GUI popping up. The first thing we're going to do will be adding a slave. So here you can click on add. We can add one first, and now I'm going to be dramatic and call this slave nuclear reactor. Nice. So we can click on add. So next you're gonna click on this icon here, and then you can go ahead and add a list of registers. We can add 10 to begin with. So we add 1 to 10. Right, add. So now what we can do, we can populate this list with a number of values. Just to keep things simple, I'll add numbers incrementally, 1 to 10. So we can do 1, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. Right. And finally, we can click on this run icon here and let it run. All right. So at this point, we can go back to our Kali attack box. So first, we can run a simple nmap scan against port 502, which is default for Modbus applications. So 137, of course, is going to be our Ubuntu target. And immediately we find this ANBAP, which stands for Modbus Application Protocol. Let me zoom in just a second. So that's our target. So in our right panel here, we can start Metasploit. So we can run MSF console. Whoa. All right, let's give it a sec. Okay, so now we can search for Modbus. And as you can see here, they have quite a few modules for banner grabbing. They have scanners. So most of these are fairly old. They date back from 2012. Today, we'll be using this scanner SCADA Modbus client module. So we can slap that in. Now let's show options. And here we have this data parameter, which is the data we want to overwrite. And as usual, you have our host and our port with a default of 502. So next we can show actions. And here you can see these coils. So coils are a data type which is specific to Modbus. And we have the option to either read or overwrite these registers. To demonstrate this, we'll first attempt to read one of these registers. So we can set the action to read holding register. Now we set the data address at 5, which is going to read the 6 value. Remember that array start at 0 and not at 1. So we're going to be reading the 6 value. So now we can set our host. We set the data address. Let's set our host. Which is 192.68.12.136.137. Yeah. And now if we run it, awesome. You can see that we get a hit, and in fact, we are able to read the 6 value. And if we go back, you can see that back to our application, we were able to read the 6 value in this array. Now back to Kali, at this point we can try something a bit more nefarious and actually overwrite one of these registers. So we can set the action to write register. Write register. Okay. Now we can set the data address again at 5. Let's put a 5. And now we need to add the data we want to overwrite. I'm going to be a prick and add lead as my value. So set data to 1337. And if we run it now, there you go. We see that we have successfully overridden this register. To have confirmation of this, let's have a look at the Ubuntu target. And as you can see here, we have overridden this value to 1337. Great. So this will be the end of today's video. I wanted to do something a little different, and SCADA pentesting is unfortunately a sometimes overlooked topic in our industry, but most certainly a very critical one. Once again, I appreciate your support, and let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Bye.